Hello there, my name is David Oyeda, and today we're going to have a short discussion about my leadership. We're going to look at basically two things, what kind of leader I believe I am, then the kind of leader I would like to become. A short while back, I took an MBTI test. This is the Myers-Briggs type indicator, and the Myers-Briggs personality type indicator is a self-report inventory designed to identify a person's personality type, strengths, and preferences. I was amazed at how this test reflected my leadership and who I believed I was. And some of the things that it brought to my attention were things I actually did not know about, I wasn't conscious about. So it brought it to the light, and I believe the Myers-Briggs type indicator was the reflection of my current leadership style and also areas that I need to perform. So in this indicator, there are a total of 16 personality types. And when I took this test, I found that I was an advocate, according to the test, an advocate. So who is an advocate? There are some strengths that I'm going to share, which is really who I am as a leader, and this is partly what I've seen in my leadership journey for the last few years. And one of the strengths, or my strengths as a leader, is I see helping others as my purpose in life. Helping others is my purpose in life. In fact, I feel that God has called me to give hope to the hopeless, and that is why I live life, to help other people. Secondly, I prefer collaboration and teamwork as opposed to dictating to people what needs to be done. I feel more comfortable collaborating with people and being involved in teamwork. And I've seen this work to my benefit because I'm a team leader, and I do quite a number of things in my day-to-day work, and I find that I feel comfortable being part of a team. Then I focus my energy on trying to convince other people instead of trying to dictate what other people need to do. So that is also one of my strengths. Another strength is inspiring and convincing are among my major strengths. I've had a lot of feedback about this. Many people have told me I'm quite inspiring and I convince them to get the better out of them or the best out of them. Then creativity in solving human challenges. I find myself very creative in this area, and this is also one of the areas that the MBTI tests showed that was my strength. And then insightfulness in how people, events, and events connect. So these are my strengths as a leader, and this is really who I am right now. And this also includes decisiveness, altruism, and passion. Then my weaknesses as a leader that I've also seen, that have also been revealed by the test that I took. Number one is people with an advocate personality type are usually sensitive, most especially sensitive to negative feedback. And of course, I've seen this affect my leadership over the years, cases where people have not agreed with me or have preferred to do things otherwise. And the sensitivity obviously affects you as a leader if you're too sensitive. And again, in a mentoring relationship, we need to be open to negative feedback as well. So another weakness I've seen is being extremely private. This also somehow does not promote mentoring, because mentoring and coaching is a two-way approach. As a mentor, I need to be open and vulnerable to the mentee, and otherwise it's also true. So this is also part of my leadership style that hopefully I need to work on as well. Then also being a perfectionist. Again, in a mentoring scenario, people are building, people are growing. And if you're a perfectionist, you can very easily frustrate people, or you may not give people enough time to transform into the kind of person you want them to be. Then also always acquiring a cause before change before any sort of change and burning out easily. So these are some of my weaknesses that I hope to work on. And when I took this test, it was to identify some of these areas that I need to work on. So the leader I would like to be. Right here, I have a picture of Jesus and the disciples. And I believe Jesus is an embodiment of the kind of leader I would like to be, because there's certain specific attributes that I feel attracted to, that I hope to be the kind of leader that Jesus was. One of those is Jesus was a servant leader. Of course, there are certain aspects of my life that embody servant leadership, but I would like to get better. I would like to get grow more into the field of being a servant leader. So Jesus was a servant leader. We see this in Luke 22, verse 26, when Jesus was describing worldly leaders and the kind of leaders that he would like us to be. He says, "But you are not to be like that. Instead, the greatest among you should be like the youngest, and the one who rules like the one who serves." And this scripture reflects the kind of leadership that Jesus promotes, and that's the kind of leadership that I would like to leave. That's the kind of legacy I would like to leave behind. A person who is humble, a person who serves other people. According to Dugan 2017, servant leaders are sensitive to the personal concerns of followers and focus on developing other people. And we see this all in the life of Jesus. That's why he's a model to me. Then secondly, Jesus was a transformational leader. Jesus chooses 12 disciples whom he mentored, coached throughout his ministry. And we see several aspects within the Gospels and within the Bible where Jesus put his disciples to the test, where Jesus taught his disciples, demonstrated what was right and what was wrong to his disciples. He even tested them when he sent them out on their own to do ministry. And I think these are aspects of transformational leadership that I would like to embody. Then Jesus boldly but lovingly instructed people on what is right and what is wrong. Kenneth Otis 2019 points this aspect out when it comes to mentoring relationships, that mentors need to be like instructors, instructing people on what is right and what is wrong as well. And we see Jesus embodying this in his transformational leadership. Then according to Dugan 2017 and also Hawkins and Smith 2006, coaching and mentoring is one of the qualities of transformation, of a transformational leader. And all of these, I believe, were embodied in Jesus Christ. That's why that's the kind of leader that I would like to be. So basically, two things. I would like to be a servant leader, and I would like to be a transformational leader. Right here are the references. Thank you very much, and God bless you.